everyone! Hola a todos! Welcome to Spanish with Manuela. In today's lesson, we will be learning the verb tener, to have. Are you ready for this? Don't move from there. Stay with us. Let's start learning el verbo tener, the verb to have. Yo tengo, yo tengo, I have. Yo tengo, I have. Tú tienes, you have. Tú tienes, 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 you have. Él or ella tiene, he or she has. Él or ella tiene, él tiene, ella tiene, he has, she has. Nosotros or nosotras tenemos, we have, we have. Nosotros for masculine plural or nosotras for feminine plural, we have. Nosotros tenemos, nosotras tenemos. Then we have vosotros and vosotras. That will be you for plural. Vosotros tenéis, vosotras tenéis. Vosotros tenéis, you have. Vosotras tenéis, you have. And our last one will be ellos or ellas tienen, they have. Ellos tienen, they have. Ellas tienen, they have. So now we're going to be learning how to use verbo tener, to have, in Spanish. For example, if you want to say that you have something, to have something in Spanish means tener algo. Remember, every time you use to and then the doing word, the verb in Spanish, our verb will end with er, ar, and ir. In this case, tener ends with er. Tener algo, to have something. For example, if I tell you, yo tengo un teléfono, I have a telephone. Yo tengo un teléfono, I have a telephone. Yo tengo una casa, I have a house. Yo tengo una casa, I have a house. Then we have age. When we're talking about our age in Spanish, we don't say I am, we say I have. For example, yo tengo 25 años. I have 25 years. So instead of using the verb to be, we're using the verb to have. I have 25 years instead of I am 25 years old. Yo tengo, I have 25 years. 25 años, yo tengo 25 años. Necessities and states. In English, you will always use the verb to be. You will say, I am, and whatever. But in Spanish, we say, tengo, I have, instead of I am. So instead of I am hungry, I am thirsty, I am tired, I am cold, I am hot, I am scared, you will always say, I have. For example, tengo hambre. I am hungry. Tengo hambre. We're using the verb to have instead of the verb to be. Tengo, I have hambre. Tengo hambre, I am hungry. Tengo sed, I am thirsty. Tengo sed, tengo, I have thirst. But we're saying here, I am thirsty. Tengo sed. Then we have tengo sueño, I am tired. Tengo sueño, tengo sueño. Tengo frío, tengo frío, I am cold. Tengo frío, tengo frío. Then we have tengo calor, I am hot, tengo calor. And our last one, tengo miedo, I am scared, tengo miedo. Tengo miedo, tengo miedo. Another way to use the verb to have in Spanish will be tengo ganas de, I feel like, tengo ganas de, And then you will need to add your verb and infinitive. In Spanish, you will say infinitivo. Those verbs in Spanish always end in ar, er, or ir. For example, ending in ar, we have caminar, to walk. Caminar, to walk. Then ending in er, we have comer, to eat. Comer, to eat. Ending in ir, we have vivir, to live. Vivir, to live. For example, if I say tengo ganas de caminar, I feel like walking, I feel like walking. In English, you can notice that you will always say walking because it ends in ing. In Spanish, when a verb ends in ando or yendo, for example, caminando, comiendo, viviendo, cantando, all those verbs, bailando, every single verb that you want to put ending in ando or yendo, that will have the same meaning as any verb in English ending with ing. But in this occasion, every time you say tengo ganas de, I feel like, and then you need to say the verb, every time that verb will go in infinitive. The verb needs to end in ar, er, or ir. So in Spanish, instead of saying tengo ganas de caminando, you will say tengo ganas de caminar. I feel like to walk. Instead of I feel like walking, I feel like to walk. I feel like walking in Spanish will be tengo ganas de caminar. You will never say tengo ganas de caminando. Another way to use the verb to have in Spanish, you will use it by talking about aches and pains. For example, I have a headache. I have a headache. How would you say that in Spanish? Tengo dolor de cabeza. Tengo means I have. Yo tengo. Remember, you can only say tengo. Tengo dolor de cabeza. I have a headache. Tengo, I have. Dolor, ache or pain is dolor. Tengo dolor de cabeza, of head. I have a headache. Tengo dolor de cabeza. Then we have, I have pain in my back. I have pain in my back. That will be, tengo dolor de espalda. Espalda means back. Espalda. Tengo, I have, dolor, pain or ache, de espalda, of back. Tengo dolor de espalda. I have pain in my back. Tengo dolor de espalda. And now last one will be, I have earache. I have earache. Tengo, I have, dolor, ache or pain, de oído, of ear. Tengo dolor de oído. I have earache. Thank you very much for watching today's video in Spanish with Manuela. If you enjoyed today's lesson and you learned something new, don't forget to give us a like and subscribe for more content. ¡Mua! ¡Adiós!